how you ask the question determines the answer.
Yeah, and this, I think, is our task. Right. So when friends who even laugh at me as a philosopher, nonetheless, with some kind of a superstitious respect, somebody asks me, but tell us, or at Wall Street they ask me, but tell us what to do, what, no, I don't know what to do. I don't have a ready.
You're talking about the fact you went down to speak to the people at Occupy Wall Street.
Yeah.
And they all want to know, tell us, you know, help us understand what to do.
Yeah. No.
And you said no.
No.
What, did you tell them, though? What was your message to those people that are down
that
there?
It's time to think. That my basic message was, and I think it was totally correct, that they shouldn't fall in love with themselves. By this I mean, what nice time we have here, this immediate freedom, ecstatic, back to old hippie days.
Yes.
No, the true problem is the day after. What of this will be translated into our daily lives, really made some changes and so on. And for this, there are no fast answers, which is why, on the other hand, I also don't totally agree, although it was probably well meant, with what President Bill Clinton said. These protests are okay, but they should translate into concrete demands what they want. No, it's a little bit deeper. We all know that our societies are approaching some deeper deadlocks, dilemmas, from ecology to, you know, status of capitalism, intellectual property, biogenetics. These are deep problems. And I want to make this very clear so that I will not be perceived as a kind of a nostalgic idiot. I'm only a communist in the sense that communism is for me the name of these problems, which are problems of the commons. Like, you know, nature out there is our common ground.
Right.
And so on.
I got you.
I'm not communist at the level of answers. I'm the first to admit 20th
You're not
century
communist
is...
in the area of Marxism-Leninism.
We can learn something of Marx, but not in the sense of easy solutions. Like, the Leninist Party is certainly not the answer. The 20th century communism was... It did some good things here and there. Universal education, blah, blah. But basically, let's face it, it was a fiasco.
Join us online at charlierose.com.